G'day flight simmers. Today I'm flying the leading edge simulation sub 340A. I'm flying between a couple of towns in Queensland, Australia. Departures from Townsville, which is on the coast, Yankee Bravo Tango Lima, and I'm heading inland towards a town by the name of Hughenden. ICAO code for the airport there is Yankee Hotel Uniform Golf, and it's a distance of about 250 nautical miles, and at the moment we're approximately halfway between both those cities or towns, and we're coming up to top of descent in about 40 nautical miles. This aircraft that I'm flying is wearing the livery for Rex Aviation Australia, and Rex are the largest operators of the Saab 340 in the world. I'm not quite sure the number, but I think it's about somewhere near 30 aircraft. So a fairly large airline organisation, I think about number three in Australia at the moment. Turboprop aircraft and fitted with the Garmin 530, which a lot of you will be familiar with. Also the Garmin 430. A lot of aircraft these days are general aviation aircraft fitted with the G1000. This particular aircraft was only fitted with the G530. And the purpose of this video today is something along the lines of a tutorial on how to use the VNAV properties in the G530. If you're flying a Cessna or another small single engine aircraft, Pipers, all those, most people wouldn't take much advantage of the VNAV facility, because when you're at low altitudes, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 feet, and you want to descend, usually it's easy to calculate your rate of descent. So you don't always need the VNAV facility in those aircraft, but in a turboprop aircraft, servicing regional areas, it's a good idea to take advantage of the VNAV facility. Now, just to give an idea of how it all works, if you don't already know this, you hit this particular button here. First off, let's go and have a look at the flight plan, and you'll see there's only one waypoint left, and that's the airport. Yankee Hotel Uniform Golf. It's roughly 81 nautical miles away. Now, if we wanted to fly directly to that airport and not worry about any approach or vectors or anything like that, we just wanted to, say, fly, descend down to the airport and arrive over the airport at over the runway at, say, 1,000 feet. So it's very easy to do that. That one simply by pressing the VNAV, and we go to push the cursor button there, which instantly lights up the target altitude you want. So in this case, we can put 1,000. That's 1,000. Well, actually, that's above sea level. From what I remember, Hughenden Airport is 1,000 feet, so you'd probably want to make that 2,000 feet. Okay, there we go. Now, we may want to sort of reach that altitude, not exactly at the waypoint, but maybe 2 or 3 nautical miles before that. So all you have to do is just dial in the nautical miles that you want. Let's say in this case 3 nautical miles, and you're going to want to reach that altitude before you get to the waypoint, not after. So we roll this along to the next one. Now what you'll see here, there's only one waypoint. Doesn't matter if I keep moving this dial around, it'll still only stay on Yankee Hotel Uniform Golf, because that's the only waypoint. If we then move down to the vertical speed profile, we can put in there what vertical speed we would like to commence the descent at, and that should then take us all the way down to that waypoint, so that we arrive at 2,000 feet, 3 nautical miles before the actual waypoint. So if I put in there 1,000 feet a minute, you'll see straight away it's telling me here that if you want to arrive at that waypoint at 1,000 feet, you're going to have to start descending in 2 minutes. Now if you alter that profile to 1,600 feet a minute, you'll notice it'll allow you 6 minutes. That's simply because when it reaches a certain point, it's going to be going down a steeper angle than if you're going to be at 1,000 feet a minute. So that's the situation. That basically means, obviously, that in 6 minutes, if I start to descend at 1,600 feet a minute, I should arrive at waypoint Yankee Hotel Uniform Golf at 2,000 feet, about 3 nautical miles before. But in this particular case, what I'd like to do is make a proper approach to the runway, the active runway. Now, in this particular case, I've checked the weather at Hughenden. There's no wind. It's take your choice. It's got two runways. The main runway is bitumen. The other runway is a dirt one. But seeing we're in a commuter aircraft, we want to be landing on the hard runway, and I've chosen runway 12. Runway 12. The other end of the runway is up 30. We're going to stick with 12. Okay, so to utilise the VNAV facility to approach that runway using vectors, we go into progress. I think that's progress. I'm never quite sure what that C is supposed to represent, but anyway, we're going to select the approach. We're going to come down to the RNAV approach at runway 12, hit the enter, and it's allowing some vectors. Okay, we've got 3 points that we can arrive at, and to illustrate that, I've got NaviGrab up here. This is approach to runway 12, and you'll see there are 3 choices of initial approach fixes. This one here at the top, Hotel Golf Delta Whiskey Golf, would be for aircraft coming in from the east and the north. Hotel Golf Delta Whiskey Delta would be from the south, and Hotel Golf Delta Whiskey Echo would be for the straight in approach, particularly for aircraft coming in maybe from the northwest. Now, I could use this waypoint here because it is coming in from the east to the west, and that would be the logical, but to give ourselves plenty of room, I'm going to go in for the straight in approach from this initial approach fix here. So we're looking at Hotel Golf Delta Whiskey Echo. So we move this down, hit enter, and asks us whether we should load it or activate it. Now, because we're well on our way and we're pretty well already close to top descent, I'm going to activate it. And straight away you'll see the aircraft starting to swing over to line up with the first waypoint, Whiskey Echo. Now we go to our VNAV situation and have a look. And it's changed It's left everything the same, except you just see there's different waypoints in here. Now, going back to our Navigraph chart, you'll see that the initial approach fix should be at 3,700. So we'll put that in. Back up here. Come down. We'll still leave it at 3 nautical miles before actually arriving at that initial waypoint, but we really want the Whiskey Echo one, so we'll rotate that till we get to Whiskey Echo. We'll leave that there. We'll come down. We're still going to leave the vertical speed profile at this stage at 1600 feet, and already it's telling us that if we want to descend at that rate, we should begin that in 4 minutes. It's as simple as that. Now, what you have to remember to do, of course, is if you're going to accept that, which in this case we'll accept it, we may as well set our initial approach fix in up the top here at the altitude select panel. I'll just get that out of the way. And we'll adjust the speed, we'll adjust the setting on that now. There we are. So, one thing to remember, of course, is depending on the type of aircraft, but once you descend, you do have to keep your eye on the speed, the descent speed. This particular aircraft does not have an auto throttle, so you can't set the speed for descent. You've got to juggle that yourself or adjust that yourself with manually with the throttles. Another thing too to keep in mind is that whilst it says begin the descent in 2:21. Sometimes you get that advice a bit earlier than what you're expecting it to be. So you might see that instead of it in 2 minutes' time, in a minute's time, you could get the notification to descend. So we'll just watch that now because we are getting close. Check outside for a minute, see how everything is. That's your typical central Queensland countryside. Pretty flat, pretty dry. So bring him up again. So watch this very closely now because, as I say, there we go, see it's jumped ahead. Okay, so what I do now is I have to obviously set the vertical speed rate. In the SAAB, it appears up the top here. So we put 1600 and we'll activate the vertical speed. Might have to do that again because it likes it the other way around. So let's go for try that again. And now we can see it is starting to descend. So really it's as easy as that. Again though, notice how the speed is climbing up because we're descending, so we've got to come back on our throttles to bring it down to about drop it down to about 180, 160. So just come back. Bring the speed back. Now, at this stage of the game, you can put this away. You don't really need it anymore. It's doing its job. I'll drop the speed back further down. Now on the sub they have what's called the TQ status viewer, and what that is I'll pop it up. It shows you the positions for your condition levers and for your throttle. Now with the throttle, if you look closer here, it does have a setting for descending with throttles cut back, and with the condition levers on descent now, it's probably a good idea to bring them forward a bit to maximum. And this needle will stay pretty well where it is now, because we're doing an idle descent. Speed's coming down, we're at 10,000. Should be able to move him out of the way now. 10,000, we can put our lights on. Get our passengers seated. Now if I bring up the 530 and put in the flight plan. No, I don't want the menu. Bring this out a bit. You can see that we're heading towards first wave, the initial approach fix, Whiskey Echo. Now obviously we want to be at 3,700, 3 nautical miles before that. We might find that it may occur a bit earlier than that, because depending on wind conditions, we could be dropping faster or slower. By the way, you can actually drag this G530 pop out over to another screen if you want. Now this is going to be a glide path approach, because it's an RNAV approach. Everything's looking good. I've left the Q&H at the exercise. It's at 2,992. And I've deliberately chosen some nice, clear, sunny weather for the exercise. I bring this up again. I'll pop him over there for the moment, and what we'll do is we'll watch to see whether we reach 3,700 a lot sooner or a lot later than that before target position of 3 nautical miles. Now I'm not quite sure why this has popped up again, telling us to begin the descent in 1 minute 45 when we're already on descent. I'm not quite sure the status of that. Notice how our speed is maintained at that 200, it's actually 200 knots. Now we're already 1,000 feet away from our initial approach fix, and I'm guessing and betting that it'll be well before we reach the waypoint. And you can see here now we've got 9, 8 coming down. We're now at 3,800, and now we're at 3,700. and we've still got nearly 9 nautical miles to go, so we are out by about 6 nautical miles. Okay, now that we're leveled off, our speed of course is starting to drop off, so throttle's forward. And we want to maintain around about 180, 160 until we do the turn to line up with the approach. Yeah, see, we're still 6 nautical miles from that waypoint, so we've reached our planned level a lot earlier. That, of course, could cause some problems with ATC. But out here there's no ATC, and it's all a case of self-vectoring. And of course, with that speed's getting away, I'll just drop that back again. The thing is, of course, you can always come over here and hit the Alt button to level off at whatever you want. Yeah, prior to that initial approach fix. Coming back again on the speed. I'm just going to activate out the CTOT. Speed's just basically where I would like it. And there we go into the turn. Now we should see the glide path start to appear here on the right hand side as we get closer. Speed is good. We're lining up here nicely. There we go, she's coming back round. At this point in time, we really don't need to have this up. We just concentrate on lining up the runway and landing her down, so we'll just keep an eye here. And we're probably we can take our first 5 degrees of slap here, flaps. Flap indicator is here. So we've got 15, 20, 35 to go. Actually, I don't think that is 10. I think it's 7. Now we can see we've already got the glide path coming to lining up nicely, and we can hit the approach, and already we've captured the glide slope. Now as we descend, of course, the speed will want to come up a bit, so we've got to pull it back. This bug here is to set your aim for what you want to land at, so that's something I'm not quite sure where that keeps going off all the time. Come back now on the speed further. I'd want to get it down to around about the 140. So we'll come back on the throttle. Come right back on the throttle. Now, Vegas Airport, the runway's about 1,000 foot high. When we reach 2,000, that will be the normal 1,000. There that goes again. Now, speed should be coming back further. I'm going to take another flap setting. Should help slow the aircraft down a bit. And we can drop the gear at this time. Help slow it down too. Now, when this particular aircraft, when you
flaps, flaps.
I know that. When you switch off the autopilot, you've got to hit this red button to stop the warning. So speed is coming down.
Approaching 1, 2.
Set up for the landing. So here we go. We're going to disconnect the autopilot. Take my aircraft. Probably a little bit too fast.
Five thousand feet remaining.
Nose down.
4,000 remaining.
And brake. And the reverse is giving a little bit over sensitivity for my foot pedals. Overshot the exit a bit there. Hard landing, but anyway, we'll make it. Flaps up. Hard landing, oh, okay. Probably a bit too fast coming in there. Yeah, she's not the easiest of aircraft to land, this one. It really likes to come in fast. I'll just take it straight in here to this track dump. Shouldn't be there. And there we go. Handbrake on. Strobe off, should have done that a bit earlier. Got our lights off, our taxi light can come off now. So can our wing light. And that's it. I won't power down the aircraft because the video was really just to give a bit of an idea how that VNAV works. So I hope there was something gained out of that. For those of you who watched it, I do hope maybe you can use the VNAV at some stage if you haven't already. As you can see, particularly on 20 engine aircraft like these flying at fairly high altitude, it's good to use it for your descent. So with that, see you next time.
Bye.